So there's one of the other topics which I think is very, very important, and I actually present this a lot, is there's different types of estrogens. And it's something that we never really got educated, as I think, as physicians. At least I didn't. I always thought and was taught that everything in the body metabolizes to estradiol. And that's the one, that's the estrogen that the woman needs. And that's what I learned. But there are good and bad estrogens in the body. And we need to start to learn, educate ourselves, and deal with it. And in fact, New England Journal of Medicine, which is our own conventional journal, in 1992 was talking about good and bad estrogens. So some of the downline estrogens are like, for example, 2-hydroxyestrones, 2-methoxyestrones. Then there are 4-hydroxyestrones, 4-methoxyestrones. There are estrones, there's estriols, there are estradiols, okay? And those are abbreviated as E1, E2, E3. So E1 is the estrone, E2 is estradiol, and E3 is abbreviated as estriol, okay? Estriol is the least potent, so to speak, and it's a weaker estrogen, but still very effective. And estradiol is what everyone used to get replenished with, and that can be good and bad depending on the woman's state of health. And I'll explain that in a minute. And then the estrones are very potent form. In fact, a lot of the xenoestrogens, which are the estrogens that come from the environment, are in the this estrone form. And the body has to metabolize it. So it has to break it down. If it can break it down into a good estrogen, well and good. But if it cannot break it down into a good estrogen and actually forms a potentially harmful estrogen, then that's the one that can trigger on the increased risk of breast cancer and cervical cancer and uterine cancer. So that's where the types of estrogens becomes extremely important, so good and bad estrogens. And the point being that, and in, at least in bioidentical hormone replacement therapy, we tend to use the majority as estriol. And estriol is a very safe estrogen. In fact, the reason being, I gave a talk on this, and so I love this subject, by the way, I gave a talk on it. There's alpha receptors and there's beta receptors. Beta receptors are actually very protective. So if estriol generally has a predilection to attach onto the beta receptors, and that's a very good thing. In fact, as a woman becomes menopausal, I'm just giving this as an example, she gets a little bit urinary urgency. She gets urinary incontinence sometimes because she loses the estrogen effect on the bladder. But the bladder has a lot of beta receptors. So why do doctors give estrace, and those are estradiol that hits generally the alpha receptors? Why are we not using estriol, which hits the beta receptors? So that just is one example of how you actually have to think things through and have to have a doctor who's knowledgeable in being able to think things through and saying, wait a minute, there is a lot of beta receptors here, so obviously I'm going to use estriol, and it's so much safer, and I'm going to use low dose, and I'm going to use the vaginal. I'm not even going to go oral, allow her liver to, you know, deal. I don't want to even have her liver deal with it because I don't know what her, how her liver is going to metabolize those estrogens. So suddenly you see how safe you're starting to make that protocol. And now you can feel less concerned about, oh my gosh, I'm going to do estrogen replacement therapy. So when you start to read the literature that suddenly says, gee, here's estrogens coming with the increased risk of breast cancer, the first questions you should ask yourself, what estrogens were they using? What kind of delivery method was it? And how much was the dosing? Those are very key elements. And again, that's a perception issue and it's a myth issue. There's so much perception and myths in hormones that's why we have such a huge regulatory, you know, bodies, the DEA and the FDA and the, you know, the state boards. Because they don't understand physiological dosing. They don't understand what I lecture about. And so they're absolutely right. The myth of hormones is always they're taken for bodybuilding and sports. So they all must be bad. Not so, if you're educated.